The average newly married couple has $80,000 in college loans and will take 21 years to pay them off. They start their marriage by financing two cars and buying a house. Thus begins the debt battle. Before we got married and went through FPU, I had financed a car that we ended up paying off, and I had some college loans myself. We didn't have a house or two cars or four cars or any credit card debt or anything along those lines. So
we were talking about getting married, and it was kind of like our unspoken agreement or plan that we were going to buy a house, and we didn't really know how we were going to pay for it, but that's what you're supposed to do. You get married and you get a house, you have cars and everything.
When we took FPU, we were pretty convicted about some of the decisions we were going to be making, and as part of that, we decided not to go buy a house like we were planning on doing. Instead, we have moved into my in-law's basement, and we've been living there ever since we've got married. And the purpose in that is we thought it'd be a good idea to pay off some of the debt that we had and try to save up for a better down payment for a house down the road, and kind of set ourselves in a better trajectory financially. Before we got married, we actually got to pay off my car like a month before we got married, and then totaled it. So when we got back from our honeymoon, we had to go buy another car, and after taking FPU, we decided to take things conservatively and take the money that insurance had given us, and we just went and bought a used car that's going to work for us for a while, and instead of going into debt on a nicer model or newer model vehicle, we went that route.
Mm-hmm. Going through the whole financial peace course has made things so much easier for us as a couple. Like, we're not perfect. We still are working on figuring it out, and there's some stuff that comes with that. But, like, we don't really have to worry, you know, at the end of the month, like, oh, you know, we overspent on this, or and there's no, like, accusing. We know where our money's going. We have our plan, and it just makes it so much easier to talk about money and even to just be like, oh, hey, I want to go get this. Like, oh, is it in our budget? It's not, like, an argument of, oh, who gets to spend what this month.
One thing that helps us in putting together our budget is using the Every Dollar app that Dave Ramsey's group has put together. It's great. It helps you kind of plan out every single dollar and put a name to it. And so we've used that in putting together how we're going to spend money each month, how much money we're going to save. And you can record the places you've spent money. So if we go to McDonald's or something, we can put in the money that we spend at McDonald's and track that throughout the month, so we know when we're meeting our budget and, you know, when we have some extra cash to use, or, you know, if we need to hold off on anything special until the following month.
Tithing has always just been, every month when we put together a budget, that's top of the list. We know going into it, we don't even have to discuss, oh, how much are we giving this month? That's just right there. We don't change it if we overspend on something or we need to put more money into another area of our budget. That's not one that gets touched for us, because we decided that's something that we want to make sure we're giving 10% all the time, and it's a non-negotiable for us.
And it's been a real joy. You know, we've come to just really love giving to the church and experiencing the joy that God's given us and doing that as He's grown our ability to give and our heart for doing so. It's just been a great joy to give back to the church and to do it freely and from a willing and a cheerful heart to say, you know, God has blessed us so much with what He's given that we want to give back, and to be able to see it bless other people in the church as well. It's just a great joy. It was fun, tons of fun to be able to participate in the All In campaign this year and be able to give way more than I would have ever dreamt of being able to give to something like that in the past. And, you know, having done careful planning and stuff throughout the year and grown in that desire to give has just been such a joy. It's really something that only God can give. We're on baby step number 3 now, saving up for a fully funded emergency fund. So we're continuing to work on that. And we're also saving up for a down payment. So it's been a real blessing for my in-laws to let us live in their basement. But I know we'll want to move out at some point.
Yeah.
So definitely staying motivated to save up each month to look to that next phase where we move out of here and are able to make a good payment on a house and do that without any other debt right now. So having a plan financially has been nice because it's given us the freedom to start saving now for retirement, which is crazy because I'm 25 years old. It's wild to think of retirement yet. But the more and more people I talk to, they say start early. And that's something that they even talked about in FPU. You know, the earlier you start, the better you're off. down the road. And so we've actually started saving for that stage in life already at such a young age. And so it's encouraging to be taking some of those right steps, those good steps, and setting ourselves up for financial peace down the road as well. If you're on the fence about joining, I'd say just jump in. Or if you're already in it, keep going. This is not going to be a decision you're going to regret. We have been blessed by going through this and have found it to be incredibly helpful, and I'm sure that you will as well.